Innovations in technology are making a revolution in the way we bank and pay for things. And today, a new report is predicting the top trends in finance for 2012.
Here with a look at the brave new world of banking and how it affects you, financial contributor Carmen Wong-Ulrich. Good morning.
Good morning. So
the first big trend here, social commerce is king.
Yeah, we know about social networking, but let's talk about social commerce. And this whole report was by Javelin, by the way, and we picked our favorites, and this is one of our top favorites. So you know on Facebook, you see the major retailers are putting discount codes and pop-up sales, but also smaller retailers, small business have pop-up shops going up there. They use a platform called Pavement to process credit card transactions, but it's even more than just shopping on Facebook. It's also virtual gaming, virtual currency, gift cards, so digital downloads as well. So Facebook is going to become, and social media in general, the place where more and more commerce is going to happen.
Talk about this shift to Gen Y. What does that mean?
Speaking of, since we're talking about online use, we're shifting over to Gen Y in terms of banking. Now, you remember I've been here talking about the bank transfer movement? Mm-hmm. That was one person upset about debit card fees, managed to get 300,000 signatures online. The force of Gen Y in terms of consumer complaints and feedback to the banks is huge. So they're going to be a big driving force in banking going forward.
That's really interesting to think about. Also, you say, well, not you say, but one of the trends here is that credit cards are back. We've talked a lot about using a credit card over a debit card just for security reasons. Is that why?
Here's the thing. The push this quarter as to why things have shifted to more credit card use, some of it also has to do with what the banks are doing. They are also encouraging folks more to use credit cards and to use credit. And here's why. The Durbin Amendment went into effect in October. This halved the fees that they were getting from merchants every time you swipe your debit. Now, Javelin found that that's going to cost the banks this year $6.6 billion in revenue. So they're going to have to make up for it. So what they're finding is that credit cards have become the more profitable product for banks. So there's going to be some shift there. Now, of course, for consumers, we've talked about the advantages of using a credit card. The danger is the folks who should not be using a credit card may start using it again, and we see that revolving debt is rising this quarter.
Right.
Just don't get one with a 25% interest rate.
Oh, how about 29.99?
Unbelievable.
Stay away.
Biometrics and biometrics ID.
Yes.
Another trend here, right?
Well, biometrics. Okay,
yeah,
big word. You know, with our phones?
It sounds
Siri,
like a big word, yeah.
Right? Voice recognition, voice technology. Retinal scans, fingerprinting, face recognition, all these things are being developed in terms of authentication to prevent fraud with your banking. And actually at the forefront of this, if you can believe it, is a credit union, Desert Field Credit Union, which is putting voice recognition technology into their online banking. Now the shift is good because consumers are actually really open to doing this and trying this. They found that 49%, and this is from Javelin, found that they believe biometrics are effective. Mm-hmm. 64%, and there's a big gap here, which is interesting, are open to biometric identification. Mm. So folks are really seeing this as a way to, I'm afraid of banking online, but if you're gonna make sure that it's me doing it, then I'm gonna be more likely to do it.
Just saw a buddy the other day, runs a small business, had new doors put in, did the fingerprint thing, yeah.
Yeah.
Crazy.
I'm up for it. Scan my retina. Yeah. If it means that nobody will make it into my account,
absolutely.
I'm up for
the last thing you want is for your account. Really quickly before we let you go, geolocation is really big.
Right. You know how if you have, you know, the coffee finder and all these things on your phone, this is all about authenticating where you're at. And it's also about saying, here's some coupons for a retailer down the street. If you're looking for some kind of product, they can find you, they can pinpoint your location and say, okay, here's where you want to go shop to save some money. That's going to have a lot of growth in 2012.
People love that. My husband keeps talking about Foursquare with stuff like that.
As long as you're not afraid of Big Brother.
Ooh, Carmen, thanks.